What can you say? I mean, you should meet him. He's a nice guy.
Well, you know. I mean,
you got to meet him.
Yeah, but you even have to read a, like, you have to read a book, first of all. You have to read a book of an opposing viewpoint. I find that a lot of people, even the secular community, doesn't read enough books of an opposing viewpoint. Because that's the only way you're going to keep refining, first of all, your arguments and how you approach the religion topic to even begin with. But even more than that, it's like, you know, you have to be willing to confront even your own doubts about what you believe. Like, I always tell people, look, I'm what I consider myself from a label perspective is an agnostic atheist, in that it's a two-part profession on what I believe and what I know. Do I believe that there is an all-powerful, all-knowing, all-present entity out there? No. But do I know that there isn't? No, I don't, because I'm incapable of knowing such things, and I freely admit this. That's why I call myself an agnostic atheist. But, you know, as far as labels are concerned, that's not going to make me say, well, then don't call me, you know, a bright, or don't call me a free thinker or anything like that. That just, I just want to be upfront to let people know where I stand on what I think and what I know.
Good for you. Now, you heard about the Rapture After Party on Facebook. What was the next step after that?
Well, obviously, get involved.
Right.
I mean, I'm going to be here, chances are, if the Rapture does or does not happen.
Yeah, I think the three of us have a pretty good bet sure still being around.
That if God did exist, he would not be doing me that favor about taking the religious zealots off the planet. Like, if the Rapture did happen, think about how good the world would actually be with no religious people.
Yeah.
Oh, but only a certain portion of them would actually be raptured.
Well, think about it. The super hardcore believers, those are the ones who want to get laws passed, you know, because they want, you know, their religious ideals in government. I mean, those people gone, we don't have anything to worry about.
Yeah, certainly government would be more sensible, and certainly the people down in Texas.
I mean, they want to pass, like, anti-evolution legislature and stuff. Those guys want to do, you know, want to teach creationism in school. Like, those are the guys.
That's scary.
So, Jerry, how did you end up getting in touch with Graydon? What was the first step there?
Well, Han, you didn't even introduce me for this podcast. Do you realize
this is terrible. let me tell everybody who exactly we're talking to as well as Graydon. This is Jerry Weaver. Jerry is the president of the Central North Carolina Atheists and Humanists, and based up in Fayetteville, and they are putting this event together up there for the 21st and 22nd, and Jerry is the head honcho, as it were, running that group. Jerry, tell us a little bit about the group up there and how things are coming together in Fayetteville.
Well, like you said, we started the group officially in February, and we were planning our coming out party, so to speak. We were going to do it in a big way in downtown Fayetteville, the prettiest part of Fayetteville, right next to the Cameo Theater at the Rainbow Room. And I heard from one of our members that he had approached Graydon about our party. And Graydon was available and willing to come. And we were so thrilled, and we started scrambling for a larger venue because we knew that we couldn't possibly house the amount of people that we would expect to come. Oh, you know it's true, though. I mean, we had a 100-person venue, and so we expanded to the Rock Shop Music Hall, and that's certainly awesome. Have you seen the pictures that I've sent?
The pictures are awesome. They're awesome.
And it's even better in person, too. So we're so excited because we have Graydon for 2 days. We can have him for the Rapture party and see who you know, disappears before our eyes. Yeah. And then and then the next day we can have a concert and really just party it up for the rest of the weekend. I think it's going to be awesome.
What would happen if several high-profile atheists were caught up in the Rapture? Like, you know, what if they take, like, two of the Four Horsemen, they take Ayaan Hirsi Ali, you know, she's ex-Muslim. They take, we need a Lawrence Krauss. We need a science guy in there. PZ Myers. What if PZ Myers goes? You know, Graydon would probably not go.
questions for God. That would be interesting, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Too many questions for God for him.
You'd wonder if they were in the closet Christians.
Well, actually, I just think that maybe God would have come to his senses and said, you know what? Maybe you probably don't have to believe in me to get caught up in the rapture. Maybe you just have to be a pretty decent person.
How about, wouldn't that be nice?
Just a decent person. But no, that'd be asking too much.
Yeah,
just a little.
I think it would create a lot of believers, though, because all of a sudden, you know, something would happen that would make you wonder.
Okay, so let me ask this question to you guys then. I think if there were any believers who are listening to this, they would want to know, what if the rapture does actually happen? Would you change your belief system?
Would I change my belief system?
Well, it would certainly cause me to question it, because anything that's an event that's outside the accepted patterns that you have must force you to assess and reevaluate exactly what's going on. So certainly, I think it would send all of us on a quest to try and understand exactly what was the cause behind that.
And I agree as well. I mean, I always try to think my way out of it by basically saying, if that was the case, though, why now? Like, why now and why not before? I mean, this is why it's just so much more unlikely, because so much more time has passed and it hasn't happened, as opposed to
how
much time that we're going to have in the future on this.
Now, I will say, if people disappeared, if people started up disappearing all around me, one of the last things I would come to is the fact that it might be God doing it. I'd be much more inclined to hypothesize that it was aliens. I've seen Stargate. They could beam you up.
Right.
There was some sort of advanced scientific reason behind it, rather than it was something magical and supernatural.
And that's my position, too. I mean, I don't believe that the universe operates on, I don't know, the God law. God just wills it and it happens. Like, there are certain things that can and can't happen. And if... let's say it depends on how it happens. Like, okay, if people disappear from their cars in motion, like, what was that? Wasn't there a show where people like passed out?
Oh, Flash Forward.
Remember that?
Yeah.
Everybody passed out. Yeah. Like, okay, instead of passing out, just say these people disappeared. So people in the cars, people in the planes, people operating the trains. Now, if the train operator disappears, the pilot disappears, the guy in the tower disappears, the guy, you know, like 80% of the church disappears, then I would think that it's God.
There was a study that showed that people who, if they get on a plane and they see their pilot praying, are significantly more scared about surviving the journey than those who would. So, yeah, and now from what you've said, I'm thinking, yes, next time I fly, I'm going to have to find out. And if I'm certainly not flying on the 21st. And if I do, I'm going to make sure that I've got an atheist pilot.
Yeah, exactly. Well, I mean, it's like, but what time zone? Like, is there a specific time?
Oh, yes, yeah.
That is just going to happen? Like, what happens if...
like so many religious things, the more you deconstruct them, the more ridiculous they sound.
And there's another part of this we haven't even addressed yet. This is the first of two end-of-the-world prophecies that are supposed to take place that aren't even related.
The Mayan.
The Mayan end of the calendar and this shit. And it's like, wait a minute, hold up. You want me to believe that the world's going to end this year and next year? Okay. I mean... you're pushing it. I mean, and I know different people have different belief systems, but it seems like the general population thinks something's going to happen in 2012. Because, you know,
so many people hope for it. I think that's the saddest thing. We can joke about the fact that people think it's going to happen, but it's when you see people who almost are desperately clamoring for the end of the world. That to me seems very sad, that they're obviously so miserable in this life, and they see such a big hole in it that they really do want the world to end and then to go off to some other ethereal, happy place. I personally find that very sad when I see that.
Hmm.
Well, I'm actually worried about the people who do strongly believe that this is going to happen. And what if it doesn't happen for them? What are they going to do at that point? You know, how are they going to actually feel when the day has come and gone and they're still here? And they spent all of this time believing truly that it was going to happen. You know, that just worries me on a personal level. You know, what happens to those people? What do they go through? How do they reconcile that? Do they think they're unworthy? Are they going to go through the rest of their lives thinking that they weren't worthy